Hey guys, this is Austin. Wi-Fi is basically everywhere, and odds are you're using one of these devices over Wi-Fi pretty much every day. However, it just got a lot less secure. Two Belgian researchers were able to find a flaw in the WPA2 Wi-Fi protocol. All this nerd talk aside means is that a secure network is no longer as secure as you think. So to take a closer look at this, we have our resident hacking expert, Wes, and you've actually spent a couple days trying to figure out exactly how all of this stuff works. So there are two types of Wi-Fi, secured and open. They've probably connected to an open network at something like a coffee shop or an airport. And while it's great to have free Wi-Fi, the downside of being open is that it really is truly open. Nearly anything you do on an open Wi-Fi network can be spied on by other people. So the idea here is that if I decide to jump on Wi-Fi, you can intercept that and see what I'm doing.
Yeah, my laptop is essentially now sitting in between your phone and whatever websites you're trying to access.
Okay, so if I say go to google.com right now, I just load it up, so I have on the Google homepage, no problem. But on your end...
And what you can actually see here is that it is showing me that you are going to a Google service. It's not gonna work for every website.
Right.
This is an attack that has been known about for a while and is pretty combated in most websites. A lot of people have the security features built in to combat this. What I'm seeing now after I started kind of diving into it is there are actually some pretty major websites that are not fully protected yet.
So from my end, this looks totally normal. Mm-hmm. I see HTTPS, it's secure, and generally speaking, if you do see HTTPS with a little green lock on your browser, you are secure, because even this will get between me and my Wi-Fi, it won't get between me and the encryption and the Wi-Fi. You can't crack that step just yet.
Exactly. What this is trying to do is it is trying to target that HTTPS, but most big websites at this point have the technology in place to basically tell my laptop to get out of here.
So, give me a website, let's try it.
Let's go to spirit.com.
Okay, it's loading. It looks fine on my end. I see it's not HTTPS, but I mean, it looks like a lot of standard generic websites.
And that's kind of creepy.
Right. I am and look, checking in.
Right there, I can see that.
Whoa!
Like in an instant, and what's creepy is it actually parses the data too. So I can see the type was a check-in. I see the last name. And
the right record there. Locator.
Yeah.
Dude, that is really scary. But to be fair, that's only on open Wi-Fi. However, sure. If you're at home.
Yeah, well, if you're at home, let's say that you're checking something personal, like if you wanted to check banking information.
Sure.
So I know some people are a fan of Amex, so go to American Express's website.
Oh, interesting. So now I see www.americanexpress.com.
Which is another tactic that this kind of attack uses.
Yeah.
Where if it can't just strip it off, it'll try and do other little tricks to essentially allow it
to be able
to
get all the way through.
Yeah.
So at this point, if you see something like this, bail. Like, this is not right. Like,
yeah.
It's one thing to not see HTTPS, and you should really look for that anytime you're logging into anything sensitive. But if you see a bunch of extra W's, that should be a big red flag.
That's when you know that something's up. So yeah, go ahead and press the login button that has a little lock next to it.
Feels like such a bad idea.
And yeah, go ahead and check your account. Feel free to use your correct credentials for this
one. I'm not gonna do that at all. All right, logging in.
And boom, I can see that your user ID is test and password is Wes is hacking. Right there, seconds.
So you're basically able to capture all that. Now that's not a real account, as you guys might be able to imagine, so it just bounced me out. But normally speaking, if that was my actual account, I would have been logged right in, checking all my credit card information, the whole deal.
Yeah, you would have no idea, and I would not only have the information, but I would have it laid out for me in color-coded fashion. So the concerning part about all of this is the people that have actually discovered the WPA2 crack, they have said that at a security conference that's coming up, they're going to release the code.
It's gonna be in the wild.
It's gonna be in the wild. So they've essentially put a shot clock on every company to say, hey, if your device supports Wi-Fi, which at this point,
everything.
A couple devices, you have to update soon. Otherwise,
it's too bad.
Not on us.
It's out there. Until things get patched everywhere, you really should treat all Wi-Fi as if it's an open and unsecured network. Now, there are ways around this. For example, if you're plugged in via Ethernet, then you're going to be able to avoid all of this. However, something you should always be doing, regardless of how you connect to the internet, is looking out for that HTTPS in your browser bar. That means that whatever you're sending, whether it's bank information, login info, credit cards, whatever, it's going to be secure. At least, way more secure than otherwise. A VPN is also a good idea. So it's not perfect. Your computer can send some information between when you get on Wi-Fi and when you connect to the VPN. But generally speaking, encrypting your web traffic is going to get around a lot of these issues. And as long as you're using an actually trustworthy VPN that is going to protect your data, you should be pretty safe. Because this is so new, there actually aren't a lot of patches that are available for you to download just yet. So Google is working on an Android patch, which will be coming soon. However, that's going to be going to Pixel devices and actually may take a while before it hits the rest of Android phones. Now, Microsoft did update Windows 10 already for this. However, even though Windows is patched, some Wi-Fi drivers may also need to be updated. You can definitely expect other companies to follow suit quickly with updates for their products, but when you consider that pretty much everything in the world that connects to Wi-Fi is vulnerable to this, it's going to take a while. And if you have an older device, you might just not be able to get an update at all. Thankfully, this can be fixed with software updates, but for now, make sure you're using HTTPS, and if you're really worried, you can consider using a VPN. So if you guys are interested in more info on hacking, I actually recently did an entire video all about it, so be sure to go check that out, and I will catch you guys in the next one.